Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you.
You know, Richard, I've watched it for years. And on Family Feud, and one of the things I admire most about you is the way you keep your composure. Uh-huh. You know, no matter how crazy the answers get, you keep your cool.
Well, I got to tell you, that's not exactly true.
You're kidding.
Once I asked a lady a question. Yeah. It was, during what month of pregnancy does a woman begin to look pregnant? And her answer almost put me away.
What month? Huh?
Watch this. Yeah. During what month of pregnancy does a woman begin to look pregnant?
September.
Minutes later, I asked the same question of her teammate. Uh-huh. Now watch. First question coming up. Oh, God. Oh, here we go, darling. No, this is coming serious.
That's a funny answer. You know, I wonder if I could have done any better under the pressure of time.
Well, let me just test you very quickly, okay? Now, I want you to answer like that. All right. Name something people do with their clothes on that other people do with their clothes off.
Fall asleep.
Good answer. Good answer.
All right.
Now, let's see how King Shriner General Hospital answered that question, and then we'll see some other unexpected answers.
Something some people do clothes that others do without clothes.
I ride a motorcycle.
The most romantic sounding musical instrument.
Drums.
Name something you might accidentally leave on all night.
Yes.
Your shoes.
I hope you won't take this the wrong way, Kenneth, but you are weird. Real or fictional, name a famous Willie.
Willie the Pooh?
Name the first thing you take off after work.
Underwear.
The next question, what time do you get off of work?
Richard, that was great.
And so are you.
Well, thank you very much for having me here.
I'm good.
My pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you, Will.
We'll be back with Jack Benny, Jane Fonda, Jack Parr, and Dick Martin as TV's Funniest Game Show Moments continue.
Because you never can tell what's going to happen. Here's a classic example from the game show veteran Bill Cullen when he was a panelist on To Tell the Truth. The MC is Joe Garagiola, and the panel has just finished questioning a team of challengers, all of whom claim to be bird trainers. Watch.
Now, Dr. Frank Field, you got us started. How did you vote?
All right, I'm taking number two. He seemed to know a little more about parakeets, so just a hunch.
Okay, just a hunch. Kitty.
I went for number two. I don't think a bird like that would cost $50 to $200, even though he can talk a little bit.
Okay. Bill Cullen.
Well, you know, we have a rule on this show that if we have seen some of the people on the show, whether they're right or wrong, we can question but not vote. Well, I have to disqualify myself because I met one of those gentlemen in the men's room, which,
What does that got to do with this?
Well, I want you to know where I met the man. Because you might...
How do you answer Kitty's question?
How'd you know he was the real one?
He had his bird in his hand.
Here's the bird man of To Tell the Truth, the dean of the game show hosts, Bill Cullen.
How are you?
Oh, no. I stand by my story.
I hope so.
Bill, that is exactly what happened. I did meet him, I swear, in the men's room. And, Bill, I have the bird to prove.
Oh, my God. Put it away, will you, please?
A little worse for wear.
I believe you now. Bill, you've hosted all kinds of game shows over the years, but there's one that you did that I thought was really outstanding. It featured little kids.
Child's Play.
Well, everything's simple for you.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. Some of the children there are hilarious and delightful.
I agree, Bill. Child's Play featured children between the ages of 5 and 9 years. And we'd ask each one of them to define or explain what simple everyday words meant to them. The results weren't only funny, they were fascinating. Oh. Listen to the way a 6-year-old boy describes the word baby.
This thing starts out as an egg, and then when it first looks a little human, it's like about the size of a shrimp cooked. And then it gets bigger, and it's like inside this wet balloon.
Would you have to be one of these again?
No, wait. Because if I was these one again, then I would have to do this my whole life over again, and I've had some pretty rough time.
Here's one from Cliffy McGee. Now, he's 9 years old, and the word he was asked to describe, Bill, is tan.
Tan.
Oh, like, so that might be this real cute girl. And she's laying back on the sun. And she lays on her back with a skimpy bathing suit. I mean, skimpy. She might be laying in the front like this. And she might land on the back like this. Until she gets the sun makes her a little, you know, brownish. Not this girl.
It's amazing how accurate those kids were with their definitions.
Not necessarily, Bill. With some kids, with the best of intent, they got slightly mixed up when they tried to deal with history. Here's a 7-year-old, Scott Stout, doing his best to be accurate about Abraham Lincoln. Watch this.
Is it the one who was in the war, or is it the one who's on pennies? I think he's the one on pennies. He's the first president. He was very brave, and I think he's dead.
Yeah. He's right. You can't dispute his fact.
The president is dead.
Well, indeed he is. When children feel what a word means but can't exactly describe it, they make up for it, well, with emphasis. And if you want to see someone who is super emphatic, here's 8-year-old Eileen Siriaco. She knows what the word retired means. There is no two ways about it.
That means, you can't work anymore. It's something like, the boss says that you're fired. You can't work here anymore. Never come back. Or sometimes when you quit, you say, I don't want to work here anymore. I want to be gone. I don't want to work here anymore. But if the boss says you must stay, you have to keep on saying what you want to say to him. And sometimes your friends, they keep on telling you, I want you to stay. But you always say to them, I want to be gone. I want to go away from here. I don't like it. I just don't like it.
I want to be gone. It makes me want to retire out of show business. Anyway, it's wonderful to see how children's minds work.
Well, you know, Bill, sometimes the kids had a pretty good idea about what they wanted to say, but they had to use a lot of words to get to what they wanted to say. Now, you hang on while 8-year-old Nikki Simpson rattles off the explanation of the word victory. You have to listen carefully.
I'll listen.
All right.
and you're so happy because of something you did or something you could have did or something that you didn't do that you shouldn't have did or something that you did that you should have did that you did and you're glad you did.